Joseph, you're a young man I can trust. You are dependable and honest. I haven't seen many of your kind since working here for over 25 years as Chief Warden. Pharaoh imprisoned his Chief Baker and his Chief Cupbearer yesterday evening. I am putting them in your charge, Joseph.
Do you know why they're here?
I didn't get all the details from the captain of the guards, however. From what I understand is, Pharaoh was on lockdown for 3 days and a bodyguard assigned heard strange sounds like yes. Something was suspicious about that.
Cast the cupbearer and the baker into prison immediately.
Yes, King Pharaoh.
We have an investigation to conduct. One of them is trying to kill me, and I'm going to find out who it is and cut off his head.
I don't feel too good.
Me either. I had a very weird dream.
It's funny you say that, because I did too.
Huh?
No way. I need an interpretation for this dreamlike recipe. I mean, like ASAP.
Indeed. My friend.
Here I am again. What's going on in here, boys?
Peace, Joe.
Is something bothering you? The mood is off today.
I'm in prison, remember? I don't know why you're always so happy. Not because you're on the opposite side of the gate. You're still in prison just like us. No disrespect, bro.
None taken, bro.
Anyhow, the deal is, I had a weird dream, and it's bothering me that I don't know what it means.
Gentlemen, no need to be concerned about interpretations. God saw the dream, and He will provide clear interpretation accordingly. So what was your dream about?
It's like I saw a vine in front of me. And on the vine were three branches. As soon as it budded, it blossomed, and its clusters ripened into grapes. Pharaoh's cup was in my hand. And I took the grapes, and squeezed them into Pharaoh's cup and put the cup in his hand.
This is what the dream means. The three branches are 3 days. Within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift up your head and restore you to your position. And you will put Pharaoh's cup in his hand, just as you used to do when you were his cupbearer.
Right! Yes.
When all goes well, you remember your boy Joseph, right?
Sure!
You already know my story. Your gratitude to me will be a good word to King Pharaoh on my behalf. I'm innocent. I don't belong here. I really never touched Potiphar's wife. She has been trying to seduce me for a while, and on that day, she just went crazy!
Pooh. Sounds exactly like my wife.
Started stripping off my clothes. I had to run.
I told her I fear God.
Joseph, I've been yearning for you. Come.
Huh?
Don't be shy, my love.
Come, play with me. My husband won't be back for hours.
How could you do this to your husband? And how can I do this great wickedness and sin against God?
He didn't just do that. Guards! Guards! Guards!
I can't believe she framed me. Anyhow,
I still can't believe you didn't taste that beauty. She came with her husband Potiphar to Pharaoh's banquets on occasions, and I thought she looked gorgeous. Anyways, I too had a dream, similar but different. On my head were three baskets of bread. In the top basket were all kinds of baked goods for Pharaoh, but the birds were eating them out of the basket on my head.
Huh. Okay, this is what it means.
The three baskets are 3 days. Within 3 days, Pharaoh will lift off your head and impale your body on a pole.
Wow, say it's a joke.
And the birds will eat away your flesh.
I don't believe you.
These are not my words.
I believe every word you said.
Remember to put in a word to the king.